Hey, Sienna, are you about ready to do the video?
What video? Oh, yeah.
Of the family? Because it's a new year and we're all going to talk this Let's Talk Raw with Brooklyn. And we're going to do a quick video. This is Let's Talk Raw. My name is Brooklyn. This is part of my family. My daughter, who's 17, is not up. And one of my dogs just went away. So two dogs and a daughter are missing. And my husband is here in physically, but in spirit, he might be somewhere else. This is a labor of love for him to do this for me. And I want to tell you why. It's been a year since I did the Dr. Phil show. My husband was there in spirit again. He was not there physically, so it was in spirit he was there on the telephone. But I have received some wonderful DMs or direct messages on Instagram and some messengers on Facebook, particularly in the last month, just saying how great I look. And I'm just really grateful for that. So I asked my husband, and it wasn't his favorite thing to do, but since we've had such wonderful changes recently in our family, which is me being back from California, and some really great things happening out there, the most important thing that happened is just realizing what is important in life. I know, what took me so long? I know. But my children are aware of the mental illness, the things that I've struggled with. They have not seen the show, they just know Mommy did a show. But I think we'll start with them on what they're excited about in 2019. And then I think, did you want to talk about what it's like to have Mommy home? This is Sienna, and this is Lily, and this is Sienna Rainbow. You might see her on 5 Minutes with Rainbow. And this is Cal Balbo. This is Daddy. He looks so happy to be here. But let's do the goals real quick. Yes, what are you excited about in 2019?
We might get a Frenchie. I'm really excited for that because I miss our old one.
We
passed away. And
French Bulldog.
Yes, French Bulldog.
A Frenchie.
Yeah. Frenchie. What else am I excited for? I don't know.
Well, you're doing basketball.
Oh yeah.
No, we're not sure about that.
I'm excited.
Let me make sure everything's healthy.
Yeah.
So that's okay. So what about Mommy being home?
I'm super happy that you're home. I don't know how to explain anything.
She does 5 Minutes with Rainbow and she gets so excited and then she doesn't like being put on the spot. So I'm sorry. Lily, what about you? What are you excited about? And what do you love to do? What do you love to watch?
I love to watch Colin Sab on YouTube.
Yeah. Because you like to dance like Everly. Yeah? Yeah, so what are you excited
about? And I just love what they do.
You know, what do they do?
They pretty much just they show their whole life.
And they're a happy family. And that's what we're working on trying to be, right? So without further ado, I would like to ask, I get a lot of questions.
What about my other?
I'm sorry, go ahead. Your other thing.
I'm really happy that you're home because someone doesn't know how to do my hair.
Well, you still won't let me do it.
Yeah, but I want better pigtails.
She wants better pigtails. Well, what are Mommies for? So should we ask Daddy how he feels about Mommy being home?
He's happy to have you home
because he doesn't have to do. Well, you know, whatever. As long as I'm needed. So really why I wanted Cal here is just because he's very supportive of me and I'm really grateful for that. This channel is something for me and the children we really love to do. And I enjoy it because I love doing makeup and skincare and I love being a part of the recovery community. Oh, we lost another one. And so it's really good for me accountability wise. And if you look back on videos of me from a year ago, even though I wasn't I was still in some form of recovery. Mentally, I wasn't available yet, so to speak. So the Dr. Phil show was amazing for me in a way of humiliation and a way of really opening my eyes to let me see how I was still acting, even though I didn't think I was acting out. It still showed how I was still completely out of touch with reality and out of touch with, I was selfish. And so I think Well, what do you think that, basically, Dr. Phil, the show saved my life by showing me how I don't want to be, basically. And also where he sent me was a very good doctors and therapists that really helped us create boundaries. Even though it took about 9 months for him to really want me to be home still. So it's really been this last 3 months that like we've been comfortable with me being here, and I've been home for a little over a month. So what would you like to say? He doesn't want to say anything about it. I want to hear his point of view on like, because you know, this is really a big deal for my husband to want me home. I know that sounds crazy to some people because we have been divorced. We don't know our story. I've been walking through recovery with addiction and with mental illness. And so for me to be healthy enough for my husband to be able to go away on business and leave the children with me, I know that this is the truth, is amazing. And it's not that I'm a bad mother. It's that I was a mother who was in recovery, using rather than being.
You're not a bad mother.
Thank you, baby. I was using instead of being in recovery. So now that I'm in recovery, and also when we go to counseling and I go to my psychotherapist, my husband comes with me inside the room. That's a part of my accountability because I was taking the wrong medications and I was being manipulative. So I think how have they changed? Like, I think my honesty level.
So for 2019, I'm really hopeful. Because it's been a long road for her, for the family, for all of us. It was not an ideal situation with the show. However, the goal was to try and help find some help that we had not been able to provide before. And then all the efforts didn't work. So the result of the show, even though it wasn't pretty, and I haven't seen it myself.
You won't watch it.
So, nor do I have any intention of watching it, but it definitely revealed some things, and I think led to some really good experiences that have really helped her see the world differently. And it took a while just to adjust, I think, just sort of some aftershocks from looking back over life and what has been, what could have been, stuff like that. In recent months, she's really made some almost miraculous self visions, maybe, or realizations. And I think that for the first time in many, 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 many years, if ever, is actually putting them into daily life and stepping it out instead of, you know, talking about it or putting on a show or whatever, or just not happening at all. So I'm hopeful for that. I'm hopeful for her growth. I'm hopeful for the family's growth. I'm super excited for the kids because they're so happy that she's home and good and doing really well, and that's great. So I'm super excited and hopeful for all of that to continue, and want to be supportive of her growth and efforts to continue, because it's not easy for her, it's not easy for anyone in, you know, a similar position. And so that also means it's not easy for the family or friends or anybody else. So I'm super hopeful for this year for that to continue to grow and realize that, you know, this is just the beginning, just the start, and, you know, a lifetime is a long time. So I'm hopeful.
Yeah. So this is going to be a quick video, and I think I want to, is it okay if we end it with a Puff Mommy Praise? So we can pray for those out there that are still struggling. Thank you so much, honey. That was amazing what you just said. And it's everything that I was hoping you would say in my heart. And this was not rehearsed in any way. In fact, you'll see that he saw the preview. You'll see that he was like, we're still doing that. So I'm really grateful. You will see my husband behind the scenes kind of around because he thinks it's a great outlet for me.
I do.
Yeah. it's really helped me a lot for my accountability.
It's a bad outlet for me.
But he's around, so if you have any questions, he's around. But I think what we'll do is we'll pray for those who are still out there struggling in addiction and with mental illness, and the families who are either in Al-Anon or not in Al-Anon, or just in general. We are strong believers in this family. We love Jesus, and we believe that between the help with, obviously with Jesus and the help of doctors and supportive family, and I have my mom and my dad and my sisters and brothers who've been amazing. It's all taken some time, but for anybody who wanted to know, my mom and I are doing actually quite well. Just recently, and like the last week, my husband went away for a little, for a couple days, and so just me and Lily, and my mom really saw that I've really changed and really grown and was able to not get so frustrated so easily. There was no crises, you know what I mean? There was just, what do you think, Lily? How do you think Mommy did, just us for a week?
Really good.
We did really good. And Lily's so helpful. And you know, I always worry if I put too much responsibility on my children because of this, and being open and honest and being authentic about what I've gone through. But as a family, we've decided it's better to be open about it. So one, they can know what's going on and they don't feel, what's the word? They don't feel left out. And also they can help others. I think it was Sienna, or both of them different times have said that they like to help people. And so it's easier for, do you think it's easier for you to help people now that you've been seen Mommy sick and like, so you know how to help other people when you can tell when someone's struggling and things like that? Do you think? They're both really, really good, sweet girls that like to help other children. They like to help everybody. They're a little adult sometimes, and I think that's sometimes my fault, but anyway, he's getting ready to be done. Okay, so let's end this with a prayer. So let's hold hands. And Mom, yeah. Pray. Okay, Trixie, are you praying too?
Yeah, hold her paw, Mommy.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Father God, I just thank you for everything you've done for my family. I just continue to ask for to bless us, Lord. And I just thank you for all those that are out there who are tuned in and who aren't, Father. And I just ask that we be a beacon of light to anybody, whether they decide to subscribe or not, Lord. I just hope that this moment right now, somewhere in this world, as many as you choose, Father, are being lifted up and just being shown the way, Father. And you're the way, you're the truth, you're the light. We give you all the glory, Father, for my recovery, for the reconciliation of this family, Lord. I ask for us to be a beacon of hope to show that this is possible. My daughter just squeezed my hand. To show that this is possible. And I just thank you so much for the recovery of our hearts and for you to have softened our hearts and from the hardened places, Lord, and to bring the darkness to light. And I thank you for all those that are out there. And I just ask you to relieve them of suffering, Lord, and just show them a piece of who you are, Lord. I ask you to show them who you are and that they are the head and not the tail. I thank you so much. In Jesus' name, amen.
I was the only one to repeat it.
All right, this is the Bowder family. This is Let's Talk Raw. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please hit that subscribe button or go below and follow one of us on Instagram. This is Cal Bowder. I am Brooklyn Bowder. This is Sienna and Lily. They don't have Instagram yet, but she has. It's Rainbow. She just started a YouTube channel, and I will have those links below as well to hang out with 5 minutes with Rainbow. Well, she has videos called 5 Minutes with Rainbow. My husband's like,
and 82
can we go?
Minutes.
Can we go? All right, thanks for joining us. Bye. Daddy? 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 You ready to do the video?
What video?
The video on YouTube.
Are we still doing that?
Yeah, we're still doing that. This is a labor of love. From him to me, and then my labor of love from me to YouTube. I mean, because I love doing YouTube. Blooper.
Just want to play with my sweet little toys.
Spoken like a true. Oh, there, and she's gone.
Skateboard.
We're waiting on Daddy. Can you believe that? Waiting on Daddy.